consumers. Wound up a little bit about a new app, and Christy Paul is all over this, where you're paying for dinner reservations?
Yeah, and that makes people go, what do you mean I gotta pay for the dinner already? Why do I have to pay for the reservation, right? This app has been called Sleazy Mike. It's been called Irresponsible. The senior writer from Wired magazine continued on Twitter, saying it's, quote, exactly what people hate about startups, sucking the life out of San Francisco. He's referring to reservationhop.com. Now, here's how it works. This app secures fake reservations at San Francisco's most popular restaurants. The public pays an average of $12 to get that reservation, and then the app gives the customer the fake name that they used to get that reservation. I know it sounds kind of simple, but there are two basic complaints here, and I bet you know them right off the top of the bat. First of all, the app makes money off something. People say, look, this should be free. It's a reservation. Secondly, unpurchased reservations obviously can lead to empty seats and lost revenue for restaurants themselves. So let's talk about this with Nashville restaurateur Patrick Burke, who's joining us via Skype. Patrick, thank you for taking the time to talk to us. So I wanted to ask you, as a restaurant owner, first of all, what's your take on the app?
When I first heard about the app, the initial reaction was that it's completely unethical because essentially their value proposition depends on people lying and creating fake names for people, which I don't think is sustainable, and it's, I think it's an unethical business plan.
Okay, so I just wanted to go through what the creator says. He's making this appeal to restaurants, saying that it eliminates no-shows by switching to a paid reservation system, saying, you know, if you've paid for it, you're going to show up. It fills off peak tables by charging for peak reservation slots. You know, restaurants that encourage customers to book during off-peak hours. And he says, we pay you. The app says that restaurants get a cut of tables booked through that platform. So when you hear those arguments, I'm wondering, do you see any benefit for a restaurant owner from something like this?
I do not, because again, as the other criticisms have levied against him, it should be free anyways. And I think that my biggest issue with it is that one of the things we say around our two restaurants in Nashville, we have another one opening in Chattanooga later this year, is that restaurants are one of the last places where people can connect and have real human interactions. We say that we help people build relationships. So the problem with this app is that it starts off with a premise of lying to the restaurant. So how can we possibly begin a relationship with a new customer, a new clientele, on the right foot?
Yeah, really good point. The app creator, too, Brian Mayer, says that he wrote the app after waiting 30 minutes for a burrito. I think basically what he's saying is there's a service issue here. Do you agree with him?
I don't. First of all, you shouldn't be making a reservation to get a burrito anyways. Yeah. Second of all, if you're going to charge people, people like to come to restaurants typically on peak times, Friday nights, Saturday nights, 7:30, 8 o'clock. And there's a reason for that. It's when most people want to go out to eat. And there is, I understand his point about trying to get people into non-peak times. That's something that in business school we study is yield management. It's the same principle as hotel rooms that are no longer good the next day or airline tickets. But this is not the right way to do it, where you encourage guests to, because the problem is you're making real reservations with fake names.
All righty. Hey, thank you so much. Patrick Burke, thank you. We appreciate it. He's the owner of 210 Jack and Zumi Restaurant.